Lake City Army Ammunition Plant produced 1.5 billion rounds last year. The plant makes all small caliber rounds used by the Defense Department. It's the largest producer in the United States. But it's no ordinary factory. Here, the process begins with soft metal and a deep sense of purpose.
The key to our success here is not necessarily in all the machinery in the buildings and the infrastructure, but in the people that work and make our product that goes out to support the warfighter.
We want to make the best ammunition to support the troops, and I think that we as Lake City take great pride in what we do.
I really feel that it's important that we make good quality product, because we have relatives over there, we have friends over there, and I really feel that we do good quality work, so when they go out there on that field, they know that they have good product from this company.
The Lake City Army Ammunition Plant has been making bullets since World War II. In between wars and conflicts, there's always a training mission, so the plant stays in business building reserves and stocking units around the world with training rounds for M16s, M60s, and aircraft guns. Quite frequently, the end users of the product find themselves continuing their ammo careers on the line at Lake City.
Most of my colleagues have their MOSs or their job specialty in the service, whatever branch they were related to the ammunition field. So there were ammo techs in the Army, or there were ammo techs in the Navy, or ammo techs in the Air Force. In fact, we have one of each right now currently in our staff.
A quarter of our workforce is former military. A good majority of the workforce have current service members serving overseas. We've got grandmothers, grandfathers, fathers, mothers, aunts, uncles, and it's easy to attribute what they do day in and day out to what they're providing and the mission that we do with the small caliber rounds. And so I think that that's something easily grasped by the employees here, and they take great pride in what they do every day, from a maintenance guy all the way down to the folks that are packing and transporting the rounds.
Whether they have served in uniform or not, the folks at Lake City have forged a bond and a mutual respect for the product they make and the person who pulls the trigger.
I feel good because I do the best that I can, because I know that they're fighting for me overseas, and no junk comes out of here.
From the Lake City Army Ammunition Plant, I'm Pam Proper for the Pentagon Channel.
Almost all bullets, though, are literally the tip of a much larger self-contained package. The bullet is the projectile part of a cartridge. Traditional bullets usually have lead cores, covered by a hard jacket of copper or brass. The bullet is gripped at its base by a brass casing, which also holds the propellant and the primer. The propellant inside the casing is smokeless powder, finely granulated nitrocellulose. The copper or steel primer cup at the base of the casing holds an explosive, which is pressure sensitive. The fully assembled bullet and casing is a cartridge, or round. Whether used in a single shot weapon or one fed by a magazine of ammunition, each cartridge must be cycled through the weapon and fed into the chamber.
Chamber is where the combustion takes place. When you pull the trigger, the firing pin hits the primer. The primer contains a very small amount of explosive compound, which produces a flame. Flame goes through a small hole in the base of a case and ignites the powder charge. The powder charge burns, does not explode, it burns, and it moves the bullet out the barrel and also gives it a twist, usually a right-hand twist, and that twist is what stabilizes a bullet in flight. Sounds simple. Took about 500 years to figure out.
The development of the bullet was slow compared with the pace of improvement in the weapons that fired them.
The earliest projectiles would have been stones, rocks, something that was thrown by hand first. The caveman would have evolved from basically throwing stones to perhaps the Edel, which was basically a spear projectile, eventually moving into projectiles that were used oftentimes on shafts, that is, as javelins, as arrows, as a spear, and also as hand arms, darts.
Around the 9th century, the Chinese invented gunpowder. Firecrackers scared off demons. Simple rockets provided delightful spectacles and were also used as primitive weapons.
The Chinese soon learned that they could also project projectiles out of tubes. Some of the first firearms were nothing more than a bamboo tube with a polished rock and some gunpowder thrown in the bottom.
It took hundreds of years for the secret of gunpowder to make its way to Europe. It wasn't until the 13th century that Europeans began experimenting with it and its uses. Soon after, they were producing the first handguns and the world's first real...